So here we are testing the lunar rover in real life. So we found this place that kind of looks like the moon's surface. So now we're testing the model on terrain, and as you can see, it works really well. I'm able to go uphill.
Help! Hi everybody, I'm Ronnie from BuWizz, and what I have here is a Lego model of the lunar roving vehicle. This one is modeled from the one which actually landed on the moon with Apollo 15 in 1971. And the last one which roamed the moon was from Apollo 17 in 1972. Yeah, what can I say about this model? It's very interesting because you can fold the wheels like with the real model and fold the seats, which Jernej will show you.
We just decided to test it, and the model has been performing really well, and it drives really well. It has plenty of power thanks to the four micro motors driving the planetary gear hubs, which gives us 5.4 times reduction, and this means that this model has plenty of torque to spin all four wheels. The suspension was redesigned, so now I'm using two shock absorbers and a BuWizz micro motor in the center. And I'm using a trick using a toggle joint instead of the CV joint to get everything as compact as possible so that this model can still be unfolded. We just landed on the moon. We unfold the axles. We lock them in. Then we unfold the individual wheels. And here, when I was unfolding the wheels, you can see how the micro motor is integrated into the suspension system itself. And for the steering, I'm using a powered up L motor, which is placed here in the center, and using a few gears for steering the front and rear axles. So now we continue, we unfold the seats on both sides. We can fix the buoys so it doesn't move anymore as much. Unfold the rests for the legs. And now we can put the tooling back on. First we have the tooling in the back. The only thing I have to be careful is the cables so they don't get in the way. So in the back we have the sample of the rocks, the gravitometer, all kinds of small and interesting tooling for rock collection and things like that. And now here in the front, we have an antenna, navigation with a chart. And finally, we have the, I think this is the battery pack with another antenna. And it simply goes in here as with the original. So the only thing I had to do modify with the let's say these add-ons was that in the rear I had to modify the rear tooling just a bit because the suspension is a bit wider than the original. But other than that, it goes together as the same as the original, and it has plenty of power to crawl over basically this terrain. And thanks to the four-wheel steering and integrated differential, which means that the inner wheels slow down when you steer, it is able to crawl in a very tight space. I know I say that a lot, that this has been a hard modification to do, but in this case, this was a really hard modification because not only does the model have to drive, steer, it also has to be able to fold, and just getting everything into such a small form factor was a really big challenge, and I'm really happy that I managed. So yes, if you want to see more videos like this, then please remember to like and subscribe. Thank you.